Clement claims his creation Print can instantly print photos from your smartphone, just like an old Polaroid camera. His 21st century Instamatic adds videos to make the pics come to life.
You've created the Print. This is the first cell phone case printer.
Yes.
You can print your own pictures from your cell phone. So we want to tear it down, tear it apart, see how she works.
Please do.
But, oh, you've kind of prepped this for me, but
yeah.
Thank you. All right, so this is looks like an adjustable.
Yep. So this is where you put your smartphone, actually.
Right. Okay, cool. Look at this. You've got hardware, software, you've got electronic design, firmware, print materials, and then you've added on top of that another level to the software that's like image recognition, and then it has to like play the video.
That's the magic of it.
Now this is the printer.
Yeah, exactly.
This is all of it.
Yeah. It's a semiconductor that will heat the paper.
Print uses a revolutionary paper that contains three hair-thin layers, each containing about 100 billion color crystals, like ink reservoirs. There's a layer for cyan, magenta, and yellow crystals, engineered to react instantly to heat. When cool, they're inert, so the paper appears white. When the printer's semiconductor heats the paper in various patterns, the crystals undergo a phase change and reveal their color, like pixels on a computer screen. Print's first magic trick converts billions of invisible crystals into an image with a full gamut of color.
We've loaded two pieces of paper in here, so we're gonna close, snap the door closed.
Okay. App.
Does that slide in just like
phone.
That?
That's okay.
Selfies?
All right, come in, come in.
Yeah.
Got it.
Okay.
Woohoo, wow.
Sending picture. Look, it's moving. Oh, yes.
And you've got your picture.
So this?
You don't need to do that.
Come on.
We have some comparisons here. So basically, this first set of pictures here comes from your standard cell phone. We got a second set of pictures here that came from a fairly nice digital camera. And then the good old-fashioned, everybody loves the disposable. So we had to shoot some pictures with the disposable. So there.
I mean, right away, my eye is drawn to this Instant. Very dark, very grainy. I mean, artistic. Ooh. The next, this is the really interesting one. One's a cell phone and one is DSLR. Yeah, you can see this is very, very, very sharp. This is a little bit fuzzy, but you know, the color is really, really great. So if you're talking about quality, I'm just gonna call it out right now.
Yeah, sure.
I don't think this is intended as a competitor to a DSLR.
No.
Or honestly, even the cell phone per se.
So basically it depends a lot also on the cell phone that you're using to take your picture, because as you saw, we took, well, basically we take the picture with the smartphone and then we just print it. And so for example, we use the front camera, but if we use the back camera, it's a higher resolution.
Right.
And that's the same. So you see it's a bit blur also, because if you're moving, well, it shows on the picture. We know that we are not gonna be you know, the same resolution as a DSLR that you print in a store,
right,
because that's not the purpose of what we're doing.
The first claim was a success. Print does bring Instamatic camera functionality to the smartphone, but that's the first half of the product's promise. Clement says the photograph will now come to life. This claim is so out there, we're gonna have to get creative with our test.
I mean, obviously it takes a picture and prints this out, but show me this magic that you were talking about.
Sure. The goal is for you not to stay still. You know, for pictures, normally you need to stay still. Here you need to move, because if you don't, then it's gonna be boring.
So we're taking a
here, that's, and I'm stopping.
So what moment, was it the very last moment?
It's the last moment. And so.
Yeah. Okay, so here we go. We've printed a picture and that I can enjoy.
Yeah.
All by itself, but there's more.
Hopefully.
What? Whoa. You just blew my mind. I'm seeing a play button on top of the photo no matter where I move it on the table, even if I rotate it.
One second.
It's playing upside down. Look at this. Let me turn it over. Yeah. That is crazy.
So.
What?
Push the play button.
Here? Oh.
And you can't really, like, tilt it.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Can you bring it up to the camera, get real close? Very cool.
I like it.
This is basically a really cool form of taking what the camera is seeing and overlaying more data on top of that on the fly.
Yeah. Here we see that first there is a square, and so we can look at it as, because we know that it's one of our pictures. And then we look inside the rectangle and we see, okay, what type of image is it? All the details that are on the picture that are recognized, is it in the database? And we pull the video and play it.
Technology, when done correctly, it basically looks like magic.
I'm done. We're buying this thing. We're out of here. Mort!